I was born in Winnipeg. I've moved and lived in Montreal. In Toronto is where I did my PhD. I took up a first position in Ottawa as an assistant professor and became an associate professor there. And then I took the leap and joined the faculty of biomedical informatics at Stanford University. This was an incredibly fulfilling and interesting environment, gave me lots of opportunities and to focus a lot more on data science. But something was still missing. I didn't want to be boxed in by only medical applications, that we could start thinking really and applying it much more broadly than that. So that is what has brought me here now, which is to see if we can realize that vision. And again, not just from me, but we're working with my new colleagues, right, and building these new partnerships to tackle interesting problems. Data science is at this intersection of mathematics and statistics and computer science, and the social sciences as well, and other kinds of sciences participate in this endeavor. So it's like a real interdisciplinary, it's a core that everybody can share. Now we want to focus on three main thematic areas. So the first one is about accelerating scientific discovery. The second one is about improving healthcare and well-being. And the third one is about empowering communities. Yeah, so Maastricht offered something that no other university really had offered for me or for many of the colleagues like me. And that is to a place that we can call home, that we can build a new environment that accommodates the kinds of aspirations that we have as data scientists, that we can work in an interdisciplinary setting, that we can work with people from all walks of the university, whether it's the people from economics or social sciences or life sciences and medicine, that we have a common bond, that we can use data, and we can use data to drive our discovery process. So in some sense, you know, the absence of or the diminishing of some kind of the barriers that currently exist at the university, which are these disciplines, this needs to be dispensed of. We need to break down those barriers and bring people together. So for me, to come here is the opportunity to create that environment. The challenge of being at an interdisciplinary interface is that nobody really understands you, right? So your computer science colleagues don't understand what you do. Your biologist friends don't understand what you do. And the statisticians just think that you're also not doing anything. But the contribution is that we take all of the methods that have been developed in those fields and we apply them to problems. And this application space, right, that is where the real innovation is occurring, is how do you solve problems in these domains using methodologies that either exist or you need to develop. And so the problem that I and many of my peers have faced is that there's no home for people like us. My father was in sales and so went where the opportunity was. So we moved a lot as a result of that. I'm very comfortable moving and finding a home wherever I am. That only really happens, I think, if you've grown up with this more fluid sense of what home is. Home is where you and your family and the people you care about are. My father believed very early on that computers were the future. And he made every effort to make it available to us even as we were very young. But I mean, he was really looking that we would get to play with it. It wasn't for him per se, but also for us. And I mean, I think I like the games more than anything, but. I know the things that I like to do and I want to do them. So it's a measured ambition. It's not big dreams, but it's what can we do today, what can we do tomorrow kind of ambition. And so it's very natural, I think, to think of it in that term, that you're having a conversation with a computer. And if it is not doing what you want it to do, it's because you're not communicating very well. It's probably the same as in when I'm learning Dutch, right? At first you have some idea of what you want to say, but you struggle to find the words. And as you build competency, then the conversations become longer and sort of higher quality and more interesting. And the same is true of programming. In the market square, there is a kip truck. And I went there, and he recognizes us now, you know. He waves from the truck when we walk by and everything. I think this is, the market is one of my favorite places. I feel really quite invited in all the things. And it's certainly made coming to the Netherlands quite a bit easier. That we can feel part of the society very quickly. It's a great way to build on your relationships, your professional relationships, right? To understand the people that you are working with and what motivates them, what interests them. We were trying to build a new community, people who want to participate in it. I mean, can we do that, right? Can you bring students that are expecting to be, you know, that they want to be social sciences researchers, to also hear the voices from business and economics, from other walks of life? And I think this is the big challenge, right? Is how do you get these different communities with their different expectations working together to craft a program that is exciting and interesting, but frankly breaks down the disciplinary barriers, not further developing it. So I think my task as the university professor is twofold. One is to bring together the people across the university that are involved in the data science mission, to bring them all together and to work together and to feel like we are the academic home for data science. Yeah, that, and also that people who look at Maastricht University for education and for research can recognize and see all the wonderful things that we're doing. So it's these two things, recognizing what is already being done and trying to build new structures that advance and move us into a new direction, this interdisciplinary and team science based interaction, which is necessary for the future, and we will do it here. Thank you.